and welcome back to our Literary Shorts program. Today we are going to be reading another story from the Greek Myths book. These are short little Greek myths that are retold by Mary Pope Osborne, who is the author of the Magic Treehouse series. And this story has to do with spiders, or really the original spider. So if you're creeped out by spiders, then this is not for you. But if you think that they're cool, or like Greek mythology, then this is the perfect place for you. So let's go ahead and get started, and then afterwards we will have a new STEM challenge for you. Alright, the weaving contest. Arachne, a proud peasant girl, was a wonderful spinner and weaver of wool. The water nymphs journeyed from their rivers and the wood nymphs from their forests just to watch Arachne steep her wool in crimson dyes. Then, take the long threads in her skillful fingers and weave exquisite tapestries. "Ah, Minerva, it must have given you your gift," declared a wood nymph one day. Minerva was the goddess of weaving and handicrafts. Arachne threw back her head. "Ha! Minerva has taught me nothing. I've taught myself everything I know." And with that, she decided to challenge Minerva to a contest. "Let's see which of us should be called the goddess of loom," she said. The nymphs covered their mouths, frightened to hear such scorn heaped upon a powerful goddess of Mount Olympus. Their fears were justified, for Minerva herself was furious when word got back to her about Arachne's conceit. The goddess immediately donned the disguise of an old woman with gray hair and hobbled with a cane to Arachne's cottage. When Arachne opened the door, Minerva shook her gnarled finger. "If I were you," said the old woman, "I would not compare myself so favorably to the great goddess Minerva. I would feel humble towards her and ask her to pardon my prideful ignorance." "You silly fool," said Minerva. "What do you mean by coming to my door and telling me what to do? If that goddess is half so great as the world thinks, let her come here and show me." "She is here," boomed the powerful voice, and before Arachne's eyes, the old woman instantly changed into the goddess Minerva. Arachne's face flushed with shame. Nevertheless, she remained defiant and plunged headlong towards her doom. "Hello, Minerva," she said. "Do you dare to finally weave against me?" Minerva only glared at the girl, as the nymphs, peeking from behind the trees, cringed to watch such insolence. "Come in if you like," Arachne said, stepping back from her doorway and bidding the goddess to enter. Without speaking, Minerva went into the cottage. Servants dashed about quickly, setting up two looms. Then Arachne and Minerva tacked back their long dresses to set to work. Their busy fingers flew back and forth as they each wove rainbows of colors, dark purples, pinks, golds, and crimsons. Minerva wove a tapestry showing the 12 greatest gods and goddesses of Mount Olympus. But Arachne wove a tapestry showing not only the gods and goddesses, but their adventures also. Then she bordered her magnificent work with flowers and ivy. The river nymphs and wood nymphs stared in awe at Arachne's tapestry. Her work was clearly better than Minerva's. Even the goddess Envy, who haughtily expected it, said, "There is no flaw." When she heard Envy's words, Minerva lost her temper. The goddess tore Arachne's tapestry and hit her mercilessly until disgraced and humiliated. Arachne crawled away and tried to hang herself. At last, moved to a little pity, Minerva said, "You may live, Arachne, but you will hang forever and do your weaving the air. Then the vengeful goddess sprinkled Arachne with hellbane, and the girl's hair fell off, and her nose and ears fell off. Her head shrank into a tiny size until she was mostly just a belly. But her fingers could still weave, and within minutes, Arachne, the first spider on Earth, wove the first magnificent web. So the lesson that we learned today was, don't make Minerva mad. And also, don't let pride get in our way, right? Don't be so boastful. No one likes a boaster, right? She was getting all the praise, but she boasted about it on top of that, right? So then she got into trouble. All right, so our challenge is the spiderweb hanger challenge. And you don't have to use a hanger. You can use other things that you can weave something around. And I just found this on a blog. But I thought it was pretty fun. And then I went ahead and did my own version. So I took a mason jar lid, and I just took some string and I wove it around the mason jar lid. And basically what you want to do is you want to get something that you can wrap it around that's hollow, has a hole in the middle, and then you want to see if you can drop something heavy in the middle of it and see if the weave will be strong enough to hold it. So I have the lid and my string. I have a golf ball, very heavy. Right here they did a hanger, and they wrapped dental floss around the hanger, and then they have rocks to put on the dental floss to see if the dental floss will hold that up. So that may be pretty fun and interesting. But I just used what I had on hand, which was a mason jar and some string. So I wrapped this string around, and so we'll see if it will hold the golf ball. And it did! So, maybe like one string wouldn't be strong enough to do it by itself, but it is interesting that all those little teeny tiny strands can be so strong together. Also, just one spider string from a real spider, I don't know the exact like how much weight it can hold times itself, but it's a ton. So pretty crazy how cool that is, that a spider can make that, you know, pretty great. And they can weave these long big webs. It's insane. They can do it fast too. Pretty crazy how fast they can do that. And so anyway, that's it for this week. I hope that you are able to do that challenge. I want to see what you do with what you have, and if you can, snap a picture of it and leave it in the comments below. Alright, well, I will see you in a week after next, and hope you have a good day. Bye.